Hey, good morning everybody. Today is Friday, May 10, 7:15 a.m. Eastern Time. Anyway, difficult to hold puts in these environments, right? Totally difficult. So, book doesn't have any weakness in the book. In another hand, right, people close their head. Market like it's full long, basically. Also, I post to you guys, you know, the same thing that I just said, you know, JP Morgan posted yesterday in their Twitter. Let me open over here. That's, you know, the lowest level as with short sales, right? I post in the closed group. Anyway, let's see. Oh. Here. So one of the lowest levels of short sales. You know, markets running without hedge. So, you know, positive gamma, blah, 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 positive delta, and that's it. And then, you know, JP Morgan came and said the same. You know, as you know, if you check the AAII sentiment, it's totally bullish. So, but that's, you know, difficult to see weaknesses in the book. Doesn't mean that the book, you know, will not see a pullback. But the majority is call. You know, I separate over here in my right side, this is the market structure document that I sent to you guys. Right, and in the left side is the current book. Just observe, you know, that a lot of, you know, calls, you know, here. So a lot of the calls, basically, you know, the opening status, the volume was really big. I highlighted over here 5,240, 5,225, 5,220. You know, this is always highlighted in the market structure document. And look, you know, the opening interest also jump. So people bought call. Who bought is always the key of the question. If it was retail or if it was dealer. If it was dealer, expecting going up. If it was retail, they will be punished. Right? They will be punished. And in the at 5,200, now 5,200 exactly. A lot of puts, you know, I mean, the 4,000 contracts were added, right? Sorry, was added. Came from 4,765, that was the opening interest, and now it's 8,000. So somebody bought 5,200 puts. Could you be that robot? I don't know. Could you be, you know, the robot selling those 5,200 calls and buying puts, or the opposite? Yes, and they build, you know, a wall at 5,200. Yes, of course, it's good. Okay, but usually, you know, this player, I mean, when we start to see this spread printing, these robots, they know how to calculate premium better than I need to see for me, you know, I need to make a read and try to make a very accurate interpretation. For me, yeah, according yesterday, doesn't make sense, you know, to be a buy 5,200 call. Because we don't need to do squeezes. Because before, look how was the delta at 5,200. Usually they print when you have like a very bullish, I mean, very bearish, you know, delta flow. And then they squeeze, but it's look like that's not a squeeze. So this melt up in the future could be a trap. I really don't disregard that could be a trap, especially because liquidity was added and the DX jump is already at 6 billion. Of course, the volatility tends to be suppressed. As I told you guys in the market wrap, I only expect, you know, volatility start to jump a little bit higher as soon as you break 5,210, you know, I put in the market structure document. But you guys already realize, you know, we have call buyers and not, you know, at least as a retail, maybe it was retail, but you, because the opening status is jumping, it's jumping. And the only place, puts was bought as well, because if you compare, you know, the opening interest, you know, left in the book yesterday, above 5,200, everything was less than 1,000 contracts. Now, jump twice, double the open standard at 5,200. So it's more than 1,000 contracts was added at 5,205. More than 2,000 contracts was added at 5,210. More than 1,000 contracts was added in 4,215. So the key of the question always will be, who bought those contracts? If it was dealers, expect, you know, a trending day to the downside. And this future melt up a trap. Okay? Could you be this? Right? I know you guys are very anxious and, you know, ask me a question like 7:21 a.m. I'm still hold the puts. I will take decision as soon the market's open. This is only futures. If I don't feel comfortable, I will accept the loss, I will close the puts. If you ask me if it's the correct decision to still holding the puts, if you see the book, the structure right now, doesn't look like. Higher GX, volatility suppressed, there's a lot of call buyers. The key of the question is always, the always is, who is behind at the buyer? Retail or dealers? If it was dealers, we're going up. Period. Period and period. But you guys see, you know, that calls jumping a lot. Calls jumping a lot, much more calls buyers than puts buyer, but some people, maybe dealers, why not? Especially because this robot over here, for my interpretation, is that they sold 5,200 call, 5,200 and bought 5,200 in put, and financing or him or herself. And if I'm right, expect a meltdown up to 5,109, period. You know, that is what I'm looking for according how I explain in the market structure document. Okay? But I cannot, you know, be blind, you know, try to create a bias because the book, the structure, so far is not bearish. But as I told you, could you be a trap? Tend to be a trap as I explain the market structure document. Okay? But, and why could you be a trap? Because, you know, volatility in those levels, VIX in those levels, you know, the puts tend to be very, 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 very cheaper. Right? Because implied volatility is low, VIX 30 days is really low, so puts are very cheaper. Very, very cheaper. And especially when the market is running without hedge. You know, is running without hedge. Okay? You guys already know that. Anyway, let's check the graphs, and I told you, I tell you guys. The magnitude is 5,235. Looks like that we are wearing back test and we fail. Okay? Note that, you know, the gamma is getting lower below 5,235. Sorry, 5,240 is the magnitude. Okay? And look that below 5,240, gamma is getting lower. 5,200, not gamma, 5,200, basically, they're burning out the gamma. Also, could you be a preparation for a meltdown? Because we are in a positive gamma territory. If they start to remove gamma in lower levels, right, it's because we are seeing no defense in lower levels. Right? Pay attention that 5,195, we have negative gamma. And we don't have divergence at 5,195 and 5,109 because you have negative delta 2. So this tends to be the worst case scenario for today. If they dump the market, as I put, you know, in the closed group and also in the market structure document, right? We could see a dump today, a pullback, you'll be a health pullback, back testing, close around 5,109. If you see that, you know, and consequently certify what I tell you guys, this melt up in the future is supposed to be a trap, right? Monday, we tend to see the continuation of the movement, and I'm expecting print 5,175, okay? But if you come up and check the Monday book, You guys, you see that they added the GX, the plus GX at 5,275. And look deltas, we have a delta support on Monday at 5,215. So per current Monday design, what I have been telling you guys about possibility to be a trap, go back to 5,109, and then continuation on Monday up to 5,175, looks like that's totally wrong according to what we have in the book. But if you see a meltdown up to 5,175, of course, all these designs will be changing, right? And also pay attention, according to what we have right now, start on Thursday, right? Because, you know, the GX jumped to 75, 60. Look that on Wednesday next week, it's already dropped to 5,225. The gamma, the plus GX. So, in some point, right, next week, you see a drop. Because, you know, the plus GX is dropping. 75, 6, 25. Right? Hope you guys understand. So, because the GX is dropping levels. So far, the magnet is for the upside. Are you pressing the same key? This week could be the top. I don't disregard. I am still looking for this. However, if you not see a pullback today, okay, I'm wrong. My interpretation is wrong. You know, I'm not a dealer. I'm trying to make interpretation according to the flow. The flow, I never said that the flow is bearish. I always said the flow is bullish, especially yesterday, because the setup is for a big squeeze and you saw a big squeeze. And so far, we are seeing the continuation of the squeeze because they put, you know, the magnet at 5,204. But remember, a lot of gummies in lower level was burning, especially 5,200. If you start to see a sell-off, we don't have too much defensor below 5,200, especially below 5,220. We don't have too much defense below 5,220. And we start to see negative gamma at 5,195, 5,109. Okay? Worst case scenario for me today is 75. But looks like that 5,180, you know, the delta start to be bullish. Okay? Could you be a trap to melt up in the future? Yes. The book is bearish? No, it is not. It is not, but they remove defense, you know, gamma defense below 5,220, okay? A lot of call buyers, lack of the hedge, volatility being suppressed. Let's check something in the pre-market. Oh, let me open my QuickSwim. It's a little bit low, my machine. Pay attention that the VIX start to spike. So it's plus 1%. Remember that I told you guys that when the VIX went below 4 in the RSI, we tend to see a recovery in the volatility in the VIX. Usually is a buy sign per dealers. I always take a note, you know, and I also, you know, highlighted in my graph as well. I don't know why it's not getting there. Yeah. As you can see in the left graph, a blue line at the RSI. So pay attention that we are melting up, right? And also the VIX is plus 1%. Okay? What we could you see and why you could melt up today? Because you know the assets that suffered yesterday as techs, especially Magni 7. Could you see a recovery and consequently make markets up and not down, okay? But pay attention that the Magnificent 7 index, that's, you know, the graph in the middle, you know, closed at 2,491 and now is trading at 2,507. It's not a big jump, right? Not a big jump. I'm still not... How can I say, convinced regarding this melt-up. A lot of coal buyers, lack of hedge, volatility in a region that usually dealers buy, okay? Lack of defense below 5,230, and start next week, the plus GEX start to drop. Doesn't mean that you, I mean, the GEX now is 5,275. You know, a lot of people just bought, you know, calls over there, right? But doesn't mean that it was the dealer. Could you be in the retail? And dealers start to set up, you know, a hedge to option structure. But I cannot lie. The book is bullish. The gamma design is bullish. But at least for today, they remove a lot of defense below 5,220. Magneto 5,240. Worst case scenario 5,280. Negative gamma at 5,195. As I said, if you see a dump up to 5,195, something that I expect, pay attention that right now is much easier to break down 5,200 because, you know, a lot of gamma was burned. I mean, a lot of delta was burned, and also a lot of gamma was removed. So it's easy to break down 5,200. Consequently, this melt up in the future could you be a trap, right? Could you be a trap, as I explained in the market structure document. Especially because the reaction of the volatility. Puts are very, very cheap. Very, very cheap. And markets is running without hedge. But let me press the key again. The flow, the structure is not bearish at all. Right? Magneto 5,240. No defense below 5,220. All the call deltas, all the deltas at 5,200 was burned. Was burned. The gamma was removed from the book. If they wanna decide to sell, we will see markets closing red. According to the dark pool, if you go to the Squeezematics, Squeezematics is a very good resource, you guys will realize that they add liquidity and they add the GX. Usually when you have a higher GX and higher liquidity, they prepare the book for something. Could you go higher? Looks like that's going higher. Everything, you know, is setting up for going higher, right? They were willing to buy yesterday. The MOC was 1.1 billion. Looks like for me was much more a short seller's closing position than the real buyers. Because if you check the volume during the intraday, the entire day, was basically zero, right? Was basically zero. But who care about volume? If they set up a structure to go up, markets go up. Doesn't care. I don't really care about volume at all. Right? Because they set up a structure, you know, to bring the market up. Period. Okay? If you will not see a pullback up to next week, especially on Wednesday, my expectation that you see a lot of turmoil start on next Wednesday. First of all, you guys have been seeing here, the plus GX start to dropping. Right? From Monday to Tuesday to Wednesday. Anyway, on Thursday, jump back up. But up to Wednesday, so far it's going down. So in some point, this pullback is going to happen. Could you start your Monday, go to Wednesday, and then market jump back up? Yes. Because the most important day for the market is the CPI and UB on Thursday. Right? We not seeing a pullback before the CPI, for me, is because the CPI will become worse than people expected, and then you could see a weakness in the market, right? But before OPEX, I'm not seeing any turmoil, and I also said that, you know, several times. And I show you guys why, especially because the open interest located at 5,000, that drop substantially if you compare, especially in the evening. Right? If you compare in the evening. And you guys have been realized that the markets went up in the open interest after 17 calls strike 5K in the money, didn't jump. In another hand, the puts start to printing because they are really cheaper. As I said, I'm not seeing any weakness before. I have been saying that. I'm not seeing any weakness before OPEX, at least in the morning. So the book start to show a little bit weakness after OPEX. Calls, long gum at 5Ks have been moving out. It's not, I mean, 5K is not being bought, you're not, the open interest is not going up. In another hand, puts is coming up, so maybe they start to generate negative gamma, negative through negative delta, right? And force the markets coming down. Of course, in higher levels, you know, puts start to be dominant, especially above 5,200, if I'm not wrong. Especially 5,200 is crowded. 5,275 is crowded, 5,300 is crowded, right? Above 5,200, of course, bulls are in dominance. Look, the open interest is much higher at calls contracts than put contracts. So above 5,200, bulls are totally in dominance. To be calm, to hold the put, we need to see the market is breaking down 5,200. Period. Period. I also highlight to you guys here and I give you guys, you know, a visibility about, you know, end of the month book. Note that 5,150 bears take dominance. 5,050 is the reversal. The reverse is confirmed. 5,100 calls are in dominance. In 5,200 calls are in dominance. So if you ask me if I'm comfortable to hold the put, so far I'm not. I need to see markets break down 5,200 because above 5,200 bulls are in dominance. Period. 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 Regarding, you know, what you do, I evaluate during the open. If you see all the dips being absorbed, I will close the puts because I don't know where the top will be. Especially because, you know, we have the plus GX to higher levels. 5,275, 5,260, and then a drop on Wednesday to 5,225, and then another jump on Thursday to 5,250. So since we are in a bullish, a bull's dominance, if I not see a drop today, at least to back test 5,109, 5,195 and close below 5,200, no, I will not hold the puts. Okay, I will not hold the puts. Period. Guys, take care.